She never misses. A $50,000 reward. A $50,000 reward. Oh, what I couldn't do with $50,000. Oh, I hate that nanny so much you think I was a mother.
Excuse us, ma'am. We knocked, but nobody answered. Are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah.
Oh, Ralph, I'm scared. Something could have happened to her.
Hush, Joe. It's gonna be all right, Joe. She's gonna be here, and she's gonna be ours again. Ma'am?
What do you want?
We had terrible troubles that back then. Had to head north to Canada. Had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
Aw, little girl. Aw, Annie.
Annie? You're Annie's parents?
Please, nothing's happened to her.
Can't believe it. Annie's parents. Where'd you say you were from again?
We come from a little farm up in Canada.
Manitoba.
Where they got lots of chickens.
Little chickens.
And ducks.
Ducks.
Geese.
Oh, you should have seen all the geese.
And roosters.
Gotcha, sis. Rooster! I never would have known it was you in 100 years.
Fool Jaggy. We're gonna fool Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
I know a guy out of jail. Can doctor up a fake birth certificate. Or any other papers you want. But we need your help, sis. For details about Annie that can help us pull things off.
Sure, I could help you. A lot. Well, what's in it for me, Ralph?
Three-way split.
Half!
What are you
Lily?
Doing? Come on. I swear you're an idiot sometimes.
Lily? Half. Straight down the middle. $25,000 each. But we gotta do it fast, Aggie. Give him some of the old rooster razzle dazzle. 2-3 minutes tops. Get the money, get the kid, and get the hell out of town.
Yeah, the kid. That's your problem. What are you gonna do with that afterward?
Aggie, that's no problem.
When the rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
For good.
Rooster!
Aw, come on, Aggie. We get the $50,000, we blow this crummy town. Then Lil and me will meet ya.
Where? Oh yeah!
Easy street! Annie is the key!
Trust.
A great deal of high-flown talk and virtually no action. In a nation racked by poverty, misery, and unemployment, it is deeds we want from the White House, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, we've had enough of your fireside chat. It is time to make real.
Criticism, damn it! Nothing but criticism, damn it!
I know.
It's awful.
Did anybody see the Washington Post this morning?
My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Franklin, you've already been elected.
every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Oliver Warbucks and Fred Franklin.
Thank you, Louis. Show them in.
Oliver.
Oliver. Good of you to have come.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Well, who is this we have here?
This is my good friend Annie, Mr. President.
Annie.
She so wanted to meet you that I couldn't resist bringing her along just to say hello.
Of course, the little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
Annie, this is Mr. Roosevelt.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, if you wait outside, I'll get you afterward.
No, let Annie stay.
Mr. President.
Having a child will keep us on our best behavior.
Thank you, Mr. President. Annie?
Harold. I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you.
Franklin, a child?
Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans with any money left, I would like to begin with your views on matters.
In the words of Calvin Coolidge,
the business of this country is business.
Yes. And for the good of you, this country, Wall Street, and me, you've got to get my factories open and my workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say, unemployment is not our worst problem. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany, heck, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that. But in the long run, we're not.
Hold out. For people who are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is it's all happening at once. The stock market has taken another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, riots,
floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone.
Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless. And getting worse.
Henry, I'd like to see those figures.
The sun will come out tomorrow! Bet your bottom dollar.
Quiet, little girl!
Harold! What did you say? No, it's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow. Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow. So you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya. Tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Harold Ickes, stand up.
What?
You heard me. Stand up. Up, up, up. Now, Harold, sing.
Sing?
Yes, sing, like Annie. I have just decided that if my administration is going to be anything, it is going to be optimistic about the future of this country. Now, Harold, sing.
But really, Franklin, you know that I...
Sing.
The sun will come out tomorrow.
Louder,
bet your
Harold.
Bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun.
Perkins!
Just thinking about tomorrow.
Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none.
Solar for the president when I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely. I just stick out my
chin. Excuse me, it's up my chin.
Oh, right. I'm sorry, my dear. I'll just stick up my chin and grin and say, everyone, Republicans too, Oliver, sing.
The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Mr. President, a telegram.
Thank you, Louis. This isn't for me. It's for you, Oliver, from your secretary in New York. Hundreds of couples jamming street outside house, all claiming to be Annie's parents, stop.
Oh, boy!
Have begun to screen them, stop. Suggest you return to New York at once. Signed, Grace Farrell.
Well, it looks as though the IRS response is more listeners than we thought. Hi, Annie.
Gee, hundreds of couples. One of them is bound to be my mother and father.
Well, I suggest you had better be getting back to New York.
Yes, Mr. President, if you don't mind. Annie?
Goodbye, Mr. President, and thank you.
No, thank you, Annie. You're the kind of person a president should have around him.
Mr. President, what if we set up 1,000 federal projects?
Dams?
Yes.
Highways?
Yes.
New post offices?
Yes. And put the unemployed to work building them.
We can create 5 million jobs within 6 months.
And weekly paychecks. We'll get all those millions off relief and back to paying taxes. We'll build a country so powerful that nobody, including Chancellor Hitler, could ever defeat us in a war.
What this country needs is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new attitude.
A new concept.
A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new spirit.
A new approach.
A new deal.
Yeah.
Perkins, gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're only a day away. Harmony!
Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're only a day.
Miss Farrell, I'm afraid there's still no sign of Mr. Warbucks or Miss Annie.
Drake, look at all these questionnaires. Do you realize I've talked to 617 women who've claimed to be Annie's mother and 619 men who said that they were her father? That makes, let me see.
1,236.
All liars. Drake, I never realized that there were so many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some of them were from the Bronx, miss.
Grace, we're back.
Where are they, Miss Farrell? Where are all the people?
They're gone, dear. I'm sorry, Annie, but they were all liars and fakes after nothing but the $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
Gee, I thought for sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come by special messenger from the FBI.
Oh, finally. Elliot Ness has located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
This sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1924.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
90,000?
Annie, I'm afraid is that the gist of it is that Ness doesn't think that there's a chance in a million of locating your parents through the locket. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. I mean, gee, you did the best that you could. If you can't find them, nobody can. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along without folks. You're doing all right. You got everything. All them Duesenbergs hanging on the wall and everything.
Oh, excuse us, Mr. Warbucks. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Annie, a Duesenberg is a car. Babe Ruth is the right fielder for the New York Yankees, and there's something else you should know. I've made me a fortune, that fortune made 10. Been headlined and profiled again and again. But something was missing, I never quite knew. That something was someone, but who? My speeches are greeted with thunderous acclaim at two universities bearing my name. Yet something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone, but who? Who could that someone be? How could she make it known? Who would need me for me? Need me for me alone? The world.